Hi, this is Frank Taylor with Nature at Your Door. And again, I found nature right outside my door. And actually, right outside this door. I'm at the back of my house, walk out basement level. The other morning, I was getting ready to put the dogs back out here. And we hadn't used the space for the dogs in a while. And I went and picked up their food dish. And right in here, where there was a web and a black widow spider. Today's episode is going to be on the black widow spider and five things I think you should know about them. So stay tuned and we're going to check out the story of the black widow spider. Right here in your backyard, you never know what you're going to find. And here's to make this invasive. It's like top. Dogwoods are flowering. And I just took a couple swipes terrestrial environment.
Produce seed pollen. And it's
black widow fact number one, I think you should know. The black widow spider is one of the most venomous spiders in North America and probably the most venomous. Black widow spiders are identified by their very round, sphere-shaped abdomen and a telltale red hourglass underneath is the classic. There's variation across the species. Here in Virginia, I think I have the southern black widow spider was the one that was outside my back door. It has a very distinct red hourglass, which I had trouble photographing. It's really hard photographing black things on lighter colored backgrounds, and I just couldn't seem to get a great photo. The black widow spider has this red hourglass. There is the northern black. Sometimes that hourglass is not as distinct or in two bands, and then across the U.S., there's variation across the board as well. The venom of the black widow is said to be 14 times as toxic or venomous as a rattlesnake venom. Fortunately, the black widow spider doesn't produce as much venom as a rattlesnake would, but nonetheless, they're very, very venomous. It's amazing if you think about the small size of the black widow spider. Its abdomen is probably smaller than your pinky fingernail, but its venom can deliver a lot of problems. People can have nausea, sweating, cramping. The venom is a neurotoxin and it works on the whole body and it can be very painful along with muscle pain and abdominal pain. Fortunately, there are very, very few deaths, and I think none reported in the United States in the last 10 years. Though last year there was over 2,500 cases reported to poison control where people have been bitten by black widow spiders. And remember, a lot of spiders are venomous. That's how they catch their prey. They're spiders, they're predators, and they capture their prey by biting them and subduing them. Fortunately, most of the spiders don't have fangs or chelicerae large enough to penetrate the skin of humans. However, the black widow does, and hence the issues that can come up with contact with a black widow spider. Black widow fact number two, and it's a good thing. Black widow spiders are not likely to bite you. They're actually not very aggressive and will only usually, and I have to add, usually bite as a last resort. Compare that to like a yellow jacket. If you go near a yellow jacket's nest or disturb its nest or run over its nest with a lawnmower or bump into a yellow jacket nest, they're going to come out and they're going to sting you. They're very aggressive. They will come after you and they will sting you. A black widow spider is not going to come after you. Compare that to a black fly or horsefly or a mosquito. All of those organisms seek humans out or other animals, and if a human comes by and there's a possible blood donor, they'll come get you. They will bite you. They will go after you. They want to bite you because they need a blood meal to get the protein from your blood to provide for their eggs. So it's usually the females that are the ones that bite. But black widow spiders don't want to bite you. They have no interest in you at all. They will try to flee at every opportunity they can.
When people get bitten by black widow spiders, and people do get bitten by black widow spiders, it's because they physically contacted it. They may have inadvertently, when they're picking something up, squeezed the spider in their hand or sat on it or put their arm on it or leaned on it, and the spider wasn't able to escape.
Besides brushing into the spider, it's kind of the same thing. If you invade her habitat by picking up a board, they like to be in crevices, or picking up some junk or trash that's in your basement or shed or your garage, and they're in there. If she is there with an egg sac, she will likely be more aggressive. There's several species of spiders that functionally guard their eggs. Like if you'll see my video on the fishing spider, that fishing spider guarded her eggs and stayed with her eggs and the offspring that were hatched from the eggs for well over a week without ever leaving even to feed. So a spider, like many females, will protect their young. The black widow spider is no different. So that increases your risk. So a black widow spider, 99.9% of the time, will probably want to flee instead of biting you. But another thing they do is they'll play dead. My spider, while I was trying to get some footage or shaking her out of a jar or putting her in a pan so I could get some close-up, she would often just roll up into a ball, pull all her legs in together, even sometimes lay upside down where I could see her red hourglass and play dead. As if, I don't know, as if that would protect her. So black widow spiders, bottom line is they're not likely to bite you. They're not super aggressive. They're not trying to get you, but it is possible if you contact them or if they're guarding their offspring. And people are bitten by black widow spiders. It happens. Fact number three, what do you do if you got bitten by a black widow spider? Or you think you might have been bitten by a black widow spider? Sometimes if you see it and you might feel pain. Other people don't feel pain. Sometimes there's two little pinpoint pricks that you might see, and there may not be any localized pain at all. Unlike the venom of a yellow jacket, which is designed to inflict immediate pain to get you away from their nest, the black widow spider toxin was designed for subduing prey, and it's a neurotoxin. This neurotoxin works on your nervous system. So if you think you've been bitten by a black widow spider, the recommendation is you call your local poison control center, get some advice from them, and they'll evaluate symptoms and instruct you what you do. Sometimes the symptoms come in slowly. You can be sick for up to 5 to 10 days. It can cause muscle cramping, sweating, nausea. Sometimes to treat that, they'll give you muscle relaxants or painkillers depending on what's going on. So you need to see a doctor and you need to watch how the symptoms of the bite progress. It's not like other spider bites where you have pain and the damage is at the point of contact. If your symptoms are severe, the doctor may decide to use an antivenom. The antivenom is created by injecting horses with a low dose of the venom of the black widow spider. And in response, the horse creates immunoglobulins that will neutralize that toxin. And they take globulins from the horse's blood and inject that into people. So some people have bad reactions to the antivenom. So they're not going to pull that antivenom out and use it for you. There's one company in North America that makes the antivenom, and it's usually used if you're really having very, very severe symptoms. Black widow fact number four. Males don't bite. It's only the females. And in fact, the males don't even look like the females. They're much smaller. They don't have that shiny black color. They may not have the hourglass at all. They're about half the size and kind of come in a variety of shades, and you'd probably never recognize them as the same species. The males also only live a couple months, and then some people say, well, that's because, you know, the black widow, how it gets its name, it eats the male after mating. That might be a little bit overrated story on the black widow spider. The studies that reported that were in a controlled laboratory environment where the males could not escape. Normally, the male comes up to the female's web, starts tapping on there, making some social gyrations that are interpreted and calm the female widow spider. But they'll also start dismantling the web. And that might be something you want to look up. That's a whole story in itself. Why do these spiders dismantle the female's web? Eventually, the male will go up there, mate with the female, and then escape. Black widow fact number five. They like to live in cool, dark, moist, damp places, which might include a basement and in nature, other places. So while the black widow spiders are in these cool, dark places, the females will produce eggs. And the bad news on that is sometimes they'll produce 200 to 400 eggs in a single cocoon, which they kind of wrap up. The offspring, on the other hand, are cannibalistic, so you'll be glad to know that they'll eat each other. Black widows are reported to spread their offspring by the little parachutes. Some spiders are known to produce a silk thread that's picked up from the wind and blown away. Most black widow offspring don't survive. Most black widow offspring don't make it to adulthood. And this is a typical pattern in nature where many, many more offspring are produced than actually survive to adults. Bottom line is black widow spiders normally live out in the woods and logs and under rocks and crevices. However, humans have created a habitat for them that they also find a suitable place to live, and that's where the human interactions usually come up. Unfortunately, the human-made habitat is also suitable for black widow spiders, and they may invade that habitat. I've also heard, and this is, you're not going to probably like this, that black widow spiders may come in the house when people bring in firewood for their wood stoves or their fireplace, and they also may try to enter as some other organisms do, like stink bugs and ladybugs. They may try to enter to find a warm place to spend the winter. Females will live up to 3 to 4 years, males only 2 to 3 months. Thanks for watching today's episode of Nature at Your Door. And again, I found nature right outside my door. I usually return organisms that I find in the exact place that I found them. And per my wife's request, I'm releasing this black widow spider much, much farther from the house, out in the woods. So thanks for watching. If you like what I'm doing here, please subscribe and share with your friends. Thanks for watching.